إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستهديه ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا من يهده الله فهو المهتدي ومن يضلل فلن تجد له من دون الله وليا مرشدا الحمد لله رب الناس ملك الناس إله الناس الحمد لله الفرد الصمد الذي لم يلد ولم يولد ولم يكن له كفوا أحد ثم أما بعد السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته Alhamdulillah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala blessed us with the month of Ramadan, already passed it. And now we're back again to our Friday lecture. Ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to accept all our deed and ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to look at us with His mercy and to give us His rahmah. Every day will come here to forgive us and to make the angels witness for our forgiveness, inshallah. I was thinking, like, what should we start, inshallah, for this season, inshallah, for next Ramadan, if we're still alive? As we said, we're trying to cope as much as we can to make a copy from the Salaf Salih. The Salaf Salih, as we said, is to prepare themselves 6 months after Ramadan, before Ramadan, and is to continue in the same manners of Ramadan another 6 months. So inshallah we'll try together inshallah to keep ourselves in the way of the manas of Ramadan inshallah, which used to come to listen to the lecture, to pray, the tahajjud and all the things inshallah. Ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to accept our deen. And I find like some very important topic we have to talk about it, which is the aqidah. One of the very important things, that's the main things in Islam, the belief. That's whatever we talk about, the belief. If you believe right, all you did is right. If the belief is wrong, nothing will be accepted from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So every Muslim should fix his belief, because that's the main thing. That's why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, when I was reading Surah Al-Baqarah, كَيْفَ تَكْفُرُونَ بِاللَّهِ. How could you disbelieve in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? وَكُنْتُمْ أَمْوَاتًا ثُمَّ أَحْيَاكُمْ ثُمَّ يُمِيتُكُمْ ثُمَّ يُحْيِيكُمْ ثُمَّ إِلَيْهِ تُرْجَعُونَ. Like, look how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has described to us. How can you disbelieve in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and He wasn't even existing before? He was dead. قَالُوا رَبَّنَا أَمَتَّنَا اثْنَتَيْنِ وَحَيَّتَنَا اثْنَتَيْنِ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us death twice and life twice. We don't live only once, or we don't die only once, because we was dead already before. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is going to give us life. We're born. And then we're going to die. And then we're going to be born again. And then we're going to be alive again. And then we're going to be back to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So how come you just believe in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and you're going back to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? Like, nobody have a brain, he can do that. That's why the word of kafir in the Arabic, or the word majnoon in Arabic, means kafir. Because he doesn't have a brain to disbelieve in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Because if he's smart, if you got a brain to think about it, he shouldn't disbelieve in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he said in the Quran, هَلْ أَتَى عَلَى الْإِنسَانُ حِينٌ مِنَ الدَّهْرِ لَمْ يَكُ شَيْئًا مَذْكُورًا. Isn't there was a time the human being wasn't existing? I wasn't existing before 1970 or 1960. Before I born one day, I wasn't existing in this dunya. So, and then when I come, I start thinking about Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Who's Allah? Of course, you have to think, you have to find Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But after that, there is people, after they find Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, said, no, there is no creator. Maybe I worship something else with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. I will worship some idols, some statues. I will worship my money, I will worship the woman, whatever. And they get away from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the one who created him, the one who gave him the life. So, very important, Allah, my brother, the belief. That's why, like they said, you cannot live without belief. All of us, every human being, we must follow some belief. Alhamdulillah, we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to choose us from the people that believe in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Because there is people that believe in the statues, in idol, they believe in the money, they believe in the power, they believe in different things. Some people, they believe nothing. The whole universal is just to come by luck. We wake up in the morning, we found it. But they still believe in something. But we as a Muslim, alhamdulillah, who believe in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and believe in the messenger Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and all the messengers and all the prophets. And when you see how important the belief But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He sent Jibreel alayhi salam to Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam physically in the shape of a human being to teach the Sahaba what is Iman, what is the belief. And this is a hadith Umar ibn Khattab. He said, while we are sitting with the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, a man, he entered the masjid and nobody knows him. And he doesn't look like a traveler because he looks like clean, and if a traveler is going to see the dust from Tumbi, it's a desert. He doesn't look like somebody traveling from place to place, and we don't know him. And he came and stayed next to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Even he touched with his knees to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam's knees, and he started asking Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam questions. Muhammad, tell me about Islam. And the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam replied, Islam, and تشهد الله إله إلا الله وأن محمد رسول الله وإقام الصلاة وإيتاء الزكاة وصوم رمضان وحج البيت إن استطعت إليه سبيلا. And then he said, true. So you asking and you know. So Umar Khattab said, he was wondering, this guy is asking and he said true, which is, I know the answer. Why is asking? And then what is Iman? What is the belief? Because there is a level in Islam. First you enter Islam. قالت الأعراب آمنا. The brethren, the Arab, they said, we are believers. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, no, don't say you are a believer. وَلَكِنْ قُولُوا أَسْلَمْنَا. Say we are Muslim, because there is a step after Islam you have to enter. Because a lot of people, they think when they enter Islam, that's it, alhamdulillah, I'm the best man. No. You still, you must go to the highest level. There is another level you must go to, that Iman, to believe in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And that's the first things Jibreel alayhi, Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Jibreel alayhi salam. And تُؤْمِنَ بِاللَّهِ. First, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And that's the highest things, my brother, because there is unseen things in our life. Nobody sees Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So how come we believe in something we never see it? We believe in Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, we never ever see Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. We believe in the angels, we never ever see the angels. And that makes us different than anyone else between the Islam and the Iman. When a person believes in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and he know there is a creator, there is a Rabb, the one who look after him. There is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and he believe in Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, which we didn't see. We never saw Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And you see people, they love him more than anything else in their life. And the same hadith of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, there will be a time when the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was crying, and he said, I miss my beloved. The Sahaba said, isn't it why you beloved? He said, no, you are my companion, you are my friend. My beloved, the people, they will come after. They never saw me, but they love me. They wish, if they sacrifice their own money and wives and children, just to look at me once. Once to Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So you believe in something, you never see it, but you even have a touch to him. You even have love to him, Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And also the angels of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, you never saw angel. So الإيمان بالله وملائكته وكتبه, the books of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, all the books, ورسله, all the messengers. We don't have a difference between Musa and Isa. We don't have a difference between Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and Ibrahim. We don't have a difference between Nuh and Adam. All the messengers, we believe in all of them. والقدر, the destiny, good or bad, alhamdulillah, whatever comes from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, we accept it straight away. And that's the true believer. Because you know that's the taqdeer of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Umar ibn Abdul Aziz used to say, I never wish to have a different taqdeer as I want, more than what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wants. Because always the taqdeer of Allah is the best. Because sometimes, Allah, my brother, you think the taqdeer of Allah at the moment is no good for me. But after some time, you say, alhamdulillah, Allah make it this way 10 years ago. Because if he didn't make it 10 years ago, these things, I will be in this side. Or maybe my son will be in this side. Or maybe my daughter. So alhamdulillah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, I never like to stay in this area, in this house. But I stay because I didn't have money to afford to go another place. And after 10 years, alhamdulillah, I didn't go to this place because it was like maybe flooding and everybody died there. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala keep you in this place to save you. The qadr, the destiny of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, good or bad, halwa or mur, even sweet or sour, it doesn't matter, whatever you feel from the taqdeer of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, say alhamdulillah. And all of us, we know Isa ibn Maryam, radiallahu anhu arda, he wanted to know which person is very close to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he loves the most. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, he's the person who accepts my decision, my destiny. Anything I do for him, he said, alhamdulillah. That's the best person. That's the person Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he became closer to him. So, the second level, which is the high level, Iman, belief. And of course, after that, al-ihsan, to believe in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala as He's watching you. And if you don't see Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala as watching you, you must watch Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And you must believe Allah is watching me. That's also high level of iman of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So the main thing, my brother, for us as a Muslims, to have a strong belief in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Because that's what we hold on. And that's what we should ask our children to hold on. Because if we don't have something, al-urwatul wuthqa, if we don't have something strong to hold on, if we take it easy, my brother, now, if you leave it a little bit, your children will leave it at all. That's why we need every Muslim to learn his aqidah and pass it to his children, his wife, and he ask his children to pass it to their own children. All the Prophet used to do that. ماذا تعبدون من بعدي؟ قالوا نعبد إلهك وإله أبائك إبراهيم وإسحاق ويعقوب. All the Prophet, before they died, he used to ask his children, what are you going to worship after me? Oh, we're going to worship Allah, your God, and your father's God, and our grandfather's God. That's what we're going to keep on. That's why we have to tell our children, this is our aqeedah. And the main thing, my brother, you need to understand, Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he come, him and all the Prophet, for one thing, for la ilaha illallah. That's it. They come for this. That's why Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam used to tell the youth, خَلُّوا بَيْنِي وَبَيْنِ النَّاسِ, leave me to give the da'wah to the people. That's all that I'm coming for. I'm not coming to fight, I'm not coming to do anything. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala never asked Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam to start fight until the people start fighting him. He was in very peaceful 13 years, he never touched anybody. His companion was killed in front of him. He never tell anybody to kill or to do anything. But after 13 years, enough is enough. So the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he used to knock from door to door. Go to the doors, every door. To the Sahaba, to the believer, to the non-believer, and this time for 13 years, only for one word, say La ilaha illallah. Assalamu alaikum. That's it. Why? Because that's the main thing, my brother. A man, he came to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and he said, Prophet of Allah, teach me Islam. What should I do in Islam? He said, to believe in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he's only one God, and Muhammad is the messenger. And to pray, and to pay zakah, and to fast, and to make hajj, if you could. The man, he said, I will do, and he left. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, if you wanted to see a man from the people of Jannah, look at this man. Look at this man. This man is coming just to believe in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and his messenger, and to follow the pillar of Islam. That's why this word, my brother, is a very high word in Islam. فَعْلَمْ أَنَّهُ لَا إِلَهَ إِلَّا اللَّهِ. You should know, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said that to Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. You should know, there is no God beside Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And for this world, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He will get people out of the hellfire. If even the iman is just like a seed, very small. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will order the angels to go to the hellfire, get out of the hellfire, everybody say it in a day, any day, La ilaha illallah. And his iman is just a little bit. But he says his word. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, one day he was walking and he heard the muazzin. He said, أَشْهَدُ أَنْ لَا إِلَهَ إِلَّا اللَّهِ. He said, you're coming out from the hellfire. You saved yourself. Just because of this word. The word of La ilaha illallah. Some people sometimes think it's small. No, Allah, it's too big by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It's very big. It's bigger than what you think. A man will come in the judgment day and he had 99 book of bad deed. 99 book of bad deed. He's 100% deserve hellfire. Finish. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He just. He put all His books, 99 books, on one side of the scale to see. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He tell him, is this true? He said, yes. He said, my katabah, the angels, they write down these things. They lie? He said, no. Did you have any excuse? No. You cannot say anything. It's finished. 99 book. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, but today is the just day. You still have something for you. We have it. A little word, you say it one day was ikhlas, was sincerity. This man one day said, La ilaha illallah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala put it on the other side of the scale. As the hadith, he said, the 99 books fly away. They couldn't stand on the other side. They fly away because of La ilaha illallah, become heavier. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, you deserve the Jannah now. Can you believe this world? Some people would think it's small. No, Allah is not. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is too big. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is something. You believe in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give you the heaven because of this world. And our belief, my brother, it's a very important thing. This is how our Islam built on. All the Islam, because the Prophet, all the Prophet coming with Islam. Different books, that's it. Different Sharia, that's it. But all of them coming with Islam. Because some people, they say the Christian religion, or the Jewish religion, or the Buddhist out, or the Ibrahim alayhi salam religion, or the wood religion, no, no. All of them Islam. Different book, different Sharia. They had things haram in this time, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make it halal to Bani Israel. Bani Israel had things halal, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make it for us haram. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make haram thing for them, halal for us. So the tashri'ah of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is different, that's all. But the main belief is Islam. And the Muslim to study the things, my brother, wallahi, inshallah, of course, we're going to take it, inshallah, like the following week. Because this topic is very important. We're going to study together, inshallah, like three sections of aqidah, of belief. What we call it Tawheed al-Rububiyyah, wa Tawheed al-Uluhiyyah, wa Tawheed al-Asma'i wa Sifat. The Tawheed of Rububiyyah. Muslims should understand what it means Rabb. قُلْ أَعُوذُ بِرَبِّ النَّاسِ مَلِكِ النَّاسِ إِلَهِ النَّاسِ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned in a small surah, three describing for himself, Rabb, Ilah, and Malik. رَبُّ النَّاسِ مَلِكِ النَّاسِ إِلَهِ النَّاسِ. And what's the difference between all of them? And what the difference between Rabb and Ilah? And what the meaning of the word of La ilaha illallah? The ulama said, half of this word La ilaha, nafi. You say like, no God. No God at all. Illallah. Except Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Ithbat. Ithbat. So that's the first things in kalimat tawheed, in the word of tawheed, is nafi. We ignore. There is no God. There is no God at all. Illa Allah, except Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Except Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Wa ilahukum ilahum wahid. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, wa ilahukum, your God is only one God. Maybe some people, that's why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he always continue. Wa ilahukum ilahum wahid. La ilaha illa huwa ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Some people, they're going to think, Muslims got one God. That's our ilah. And Jews got God. That's the ilah. And that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, La ilaha illa huwa. It's only one ilah. Only one God, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So that's how we can build our generation, inshallah, for the tawheed, for the aqidah of the Muslims. Main thing, my brother, inshallah, what we're going to study? We're going to study the tawheed al-rububiyyah, as I said, which a person should to understand what it means, Rabb. The Rabb is the one look after you. You are the house, you are Rabb al-Usra. You are the one who look after your family. You're the one, if a children sick, you take them to the doctor. The mother, when you get the father get the medicine from the doctor, the mother, she wake up in the night to give the medicine. Or she clean for them. The father, he want to work. You're the Rabb al-Usra. You want to look after. And when you know Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he look after us. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala look after us for everything. Everything in our life, from A to Z, nothing without Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala look after you for your rizq. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala look after you for your children. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala look after you even in your body. When you sleep, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala look after you. You cannot control your breath. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala control it for you. You cannot control your turning over in the night when you're sleeping. And the ulama said, if you sleep for a long time on one side, maybe you wake up in the morning, it will be dead, no blood. So there is angels all the night turning you over. So, وَنُقَلِّبْهُمْ ذَاتَ الْيَمِينِ وَذَاتَ الشِّمَالِ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is to do that with Ashab al-Kahf. 309 years, there is a special angel for them to look after them, to turn them. You cannot sleep on one side. The doctor knows that very well. You have to turn over, otherwise you're going to start like, been eating from all these germs and things like that. So, subhanAllah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he look after you even when you're sleeping. Your heart is working because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala look after you. And La ilaha illallah, which we said, Tawheed al-Rububiyyah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he's the Rabb, he's the one who look after us. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he's the creator. And when you talk about the Creator, He's the only one deserves to be worshipped. La ilaha illallah. He's the only one deserves to be worshipped. No one else. Why? Because He's the one who created you. He's the one who created everything on this earth. Nothing. وَلَئِنْ سَأَلْتَهُمْ Even the non-believer. When you ask them, وَلَئِنْ سَأَلْتَهُمْ مَنْ خَلَقَهُمْ لَيَقُلُنَّ اللَّهُ If you ask them who created you, they will say Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَلَئِنْ سَأَلْتَهُمْ مَنْ خَلَقَ السَّمَوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضِ لَيَقُلُنَّ اللَّهُ If you ask them who created the heaven and the earth, they will say Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So they know. But they still having partner with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The people in Quraysh before Islam, they used to make tawaf and used to say لَبَّيْكَ اللَّهُمَّ لَبَّيْكَ لَبَّيْكَ لَا شَرِيكَ لَكَ لَبَّيْكَ There is no partner to you. إِلَّا شَرِيكًا هُوَ لَكَ وَمَا مَلَكَ وَمَا مَلَكَ Except one, he's your partner and you owe him whatever he owns as well. How come? But these people, they used to make tawaf and they used to say لَبَّيْكَ اللَّهُمَّ لَبَّيْكَ لَبَّيْكَ لَا شَرِيكَ لَكَ لَبَّيْكَ إِلَّا شَرِيكًا تَمْلُكُ وَمَا مَلَكَ Except one partner, and you owe him whatever he owes as well. So these people still know Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He's a creator, but he still has partner. Like exactly what the Christian they make. They said Isa ibn Allah. Like the Jewish, they said Uzair ibn Allah. And all the things Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he did create us because he need like some company, or he feel lonely, so Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created us. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created us to worship Him. وَمَا خَلَقْتُ الْجِنَّ وَالْإِنسَ إِلَّا لِيَعْبُدُونَ The only reason for us to be worshipped in this dunya, to be slave to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And that's the highest things in Islam, to be slave to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So you must believe in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala as a God. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He's a creator. And you must know the name and the attribute of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Which inshallah our course is going to be on like more details what we start in Ramadan about the name and the attribute, but inshallah we're gonna take it in more details to know Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Because wallahi my brother, when you know a person, you will love him more. And every time you know Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, you will love Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala more. When you know who's Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala ar-Rahim, you will love Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Who's Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala ar-Rahman, you will love ar-Rahman. Ar-Rahman fas'al bihi khabira. You need to get some knowledge to know Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And this, inshallah, the Fridays, inshallah, which is coming, we're gonna take it together. Today, only just what like introducing about what we're gonna talk about, it, inshallah. But from next week, inshallah, we're gonna have our PowerPoint, inshallah, and we'll talk about one of the very important, inshallah, whoever know any brother, he need to know about aqidah. Wallah, my brother, it's very important because that's the most important things in the Muslim's life. That's the thing can save yourself. Save your family, save your children. Nobody will live forever. You can die anytime. If you leave your children with a strong aqidah, don't be scared after that, inshallah. Because they're going to raise their own children in the same way. But if they don't have aqidah, strong aqidah, my brother, wallahi, wallahi, anything can happen. After some time, they will believe, maybe there is no God. The Prophet ﷺ said, the shaitan will come to you and ask you, who created the sun? The answer will be straight away, Allah. Who created the moon? The answer, Allah, who created the planet? Allah, who created the tree? Allah, who created mankind? Allah, who created jinn? Allah, everything Allah. Until he drag you to ask you, who created Allah? And in this, the Prophet ﷺ said, as soon as he asks you this question, say, Amantu billah. Say, I believe in Allah. That's it, close the topic. Because you cannot get to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, nobody created him. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he's a creator. So for us, to put our children on a strong belief from now, that's very important for us, wallahi. Before somebody come to tell them, look, we don't see Allah. How come you worship something you don't see it? Like, I think that was a question between a teacher and the student. And the student was a Muslim, and the teacher was telling him, he's not a Muslim. He said, there is nothing called it Allah because he's not existing. We cannot see him. We don't see Allah. And the boy was saying, no, Allah is everywhere. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, you want to create us, Allah. He said, no, show me Allah. So the boy said to him, like, you can see the light, but you cannot see the electricity. Not everything you cannot see is not existing. You can breathe, but you cannot see the air. And the teacher is still stubbornly saying, I cannot see your brain, so you are crazy. Because if you got a brain, I should see it. But the student, like, he was trying to let him believe in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And not everything, you cannot see it, it doesn't exist. As I said, we breathe, we feel, there is an air, otherwise we'll die. But we cannot see the air. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He's a creator, He's the one who deserves us to worship Him. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He's the Rabb, the one who look after all His creator, His creation. And Muslim, if you hold on this aqidah, inshallah will be saved. Because wallahi, my brother, that's the main thing. So whatever you do in your dunya, if you come in the end, man kana akhiru kalamuhu la ilaha illallah dakhala al-jannah. The person, his last word to be la ilaha illallah will enter the jannah, inshallah. So, but don't think it's easy. You're gonna say it doesn't matter. But when I die, I will say it. No, wallahi. That's from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. ثَبِّتُ اللَّهُ الَّذِينَ أَمَنُوا بِالْقَوْلِ الثَّابِتِ فِي الْحَيَاةِ الدُّنْيَا وَفِي الْآخِرَةِ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will support you in the dunya with this word, with la ilaha illallah. Jibreel alayhi salam, he comes to you to let you say it easy. Angel comes to you to ask you to say it easy. Because the person when you die, it's not easy for him to talk. You don't know the situation. Not everybody can say it. It's from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That's why we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to let us die in the state of Islam, and let us die, and the last word we say it, inshallah, la ilaha illallah. Inshallah, next week, as I said, we're going to, inshallah, start talk about Tawheed al-Rububiyyah and Tawheed al-Uluhiyyah, and then, inshallah, we're going to start take the names of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and attribute. أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله لي ولكم سبحانك اللهم وبحمدك نستغفرك ونتوب إليك بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم والعصر إن الإنسان في خسر إلا الذين آمنوا وعملوا الصالحات وتواصوا بالحق وتواصوا بالصبر سبحان ربك رب العزة عما يصفون وسلام على المرسلين والحمد لله رب العالمين وجزاك